Hello.
G'day.
Good day.
Hello.
Hi. My name's Diana, and I've got Nicole and Jay on the phone with me as well. We're so excited for the Australian tour. We just wanted to tell you that. And there have been some rumours the past few days, and we were hoping that you could squash them for us right now and confirm that you are definitely still coming here in August.
Donnie is chewing on his gum to assure good breath because Jen now has moved to about half an inch from his face.
Are y'all going to make out?
Jen and I have just made plans to go to Waffle House for lunch.
You didn't even hear the question.
Piccadilly's for dinner. Piccadilly cafeteria.
That's real nice and fancy.
As of now, it's all good.
As of now. So that indicates to me you know something that you can't go public with.
Brother, I'm in Atlanta. I'm not ready to talk about Australia. We got a big show tonight.
What about Vegas? We'll be in Vegas.
Hey.
Can we talk to you there?
I'm guessing they don't miss one chance to go to Vegas. They got a stripper pole on their bus.
Oh, no.
If Vegas is on the list somewhere.
To Vegas, and we can't wait to see you guys there and get full service in meet and greet.
Look at that.
We'd rather be full service down under, but Vegas will do.
Okay,
let's start with Vegas. And you can take whatever happens in Vegas back to Australia with you and spread the word.
Oh, that sounds fantastic.
Jen just slapped me, by the way.
Are you getting jealous, Jen?
Totally.
You do know that you're keeping the R&B voice on, right? You're stuck on that now.
Jen's sitting so close to me, I just got to stay on my game.
But they're, I'm trying to take a picture to put on Twitter,
yeah.
And Jen won't stop moving. Like, she's like almost like... like a child who got their greatest toy ever for Christmas.
Well,
and now
it is.
Just
Donnie is Jen's greatest toy.
Amazing toy.
Jen, right here. Okay. Don't hold still. Ready? There you go.
She's flustered, man.
Danny, see, that's the thing. That's the thing. Kids today, they can write like OMFG on their text messages. Mm-hmm. And we don't, you know, they have all these secret codes. And we're all like panicked, like as parents, like, what does this mean? They're sending sexual code, you know, like Morse code and stuff. And, you know, but they don't have R&B voices today. they don't even have voices. They don't even know about an R&B voice.
I think there's an iPhone application for that.
You think you can get one?
I think you can get that now.
Danny's just shaking his head like, man, I've seen this now years and years and years.
Oh, he's doing it.
Danny and I have been going to, we started in kindergarten together, so you know, all the way through high school. Had jobs together and joined the group together.
Who is the better wingman when you guys are single and you're out? Who is the better wingman?
I would say it's equal.
Yeah?
I mean, we always look out for each other, no matter what.
We were trying to explain the whole dibs theory. You guys know about this with women earlier this morning?
It's definitely happened with you guys and New Kids fans.
Yeah, we can tell who calls dibs on who right now. No, girls call dibs. As soon as they see a guy, we call dibs on the guy we see first.
Really?
And that girl gets that guy.
Yeah.
And then the other girls help that girl get that guy for the night.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So Jen had dibs on Donnie, you know, before you walked in the door.
Yeah, so we can't mess
with
Donnie.
Like the seventh grade.
So here's the bottom line.
Like, it's a lifetime.
Kind of like guys, when we're young, we like, that's my car. When cars drive by, my car.
But it doesn't print the same way with guys. Like, for instance, this is a lifetime dib. So
lifetime.
If Jen called dibs on you, Donnie, mm-hmm. before you got into the studio, none of these girls... ever would be able
you.
To go
she,
out with you unless they got her permission.
We couldn't touch you.
She got dibs on you in 1980 what?
Really?
We don't have to ask permission.
We don't do that. I mean, guys don't do that. It's just
girls do.
In the moment, whatever happens, if Donnie said, yo, who's that girl? That would be it, you know? It's simple.
I think I was trying to explain to them earlier this morning that for us guys, it's all about getting physical with a woman. And if we can't, the next best thing for us is to make sure our best guy is getting hooked up. So we would never block that. Where women block each other, guys will assist each other.
Yeah, it's called, we can't say what that's called on the radio.
We know.
Yes.
I mean, well, we assist,
blockage.
But we just assist with the one guy.
Right. The dibs basically is telling the girl group, hey, that's the guy I want to get with, so all the girls get together and help her get him. So we're helping each other, too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's great.
I want to know, since you guys have been friends for so long, what was your biggest fight about?
Dibs.
Yeah.
Dibs. Well, we never really had any big fights.
Not fisticuffs. You guys never went at it.
Not with other members of the group, maybe, but not me and Donnie. I mean, it's just, it's not like that.
Who's come?
Yeah.
Who's,
all right, so, yeah.
Yeah, who's come to blows in the band?
No one.
We'll keep that a no comment.
Was there ever, almost, it was almost one fist fight years ago. John and Joe. Figure that out. Joe, no, Joe was about 14. I mean, it was just, it was so long ago. It didn't add up.
It wasn't going to be a good fight, even if it really happened.
Joe was so young. I mean,
he was spunky. Fiery.
Yeah, he's very spunky, though. I mean that in the most kind-hearted of ways.
Janet is calling from New York. We have no Atlanta callers for you. Just it's New York, it's Colorado, it's Canada, it's good Australia. Morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
Hi, wow. Can you hear me?
Is she in the shower?
Where are you calling from?
Perhaps you should get out of the laundromat.
Hello?
Yeah, go ahead.
Good morning. Hi, I'm calling from Long Island.
Okay, Long Island, you are on the phone.
Hi, is the New Kids there?
They're here.
Oh, my God. Hi, guys. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Late for work, but it doesn't matter now. This is the best. Guys, I've been trying to tweet this to you for the longest time. I want to thank you and thank your families, most important, for sharing you guys with us. I cannot get over how wonderful this has been, such a ride, to bring me back to my years when I was younger. Thank you guys so much, and thank your families, please.
That's awesome.
Thank you.
Well, you're really welcome. Cool. Thank you.
I told these guys before you came in, I don't know that I have ever seen a band with more passionate fans than you guys have, right? And I'm sure it's nuts in every city that you guys go to. All these women want to get their hands on you. But in all honesty, has it ever gotten to a point where it was scary for any of you guys?